go ahead and leave it on. When I cut the first log, I cut it with this tension line up, but it turns out I cut it, the beams work this way, and this way, and this time instead of putting this side up, I'm gonna go directly perpendicular to it, put this side up, cut my beams right here, right here.
The outside of the log has the clearest wood.
Mm-hmm.
So I'll saw this down. If I'm going to saw, for example, 8 by 10, so they have to be 8 inches wide this way, that means I need a flat top of 16 inches or about right there.
Okay.
But the farther I can get away from the center, the pith of the log, the better mm-hmm. the quality of the beam. So it's nice to be, if you can, cut a 4-inch swath out of the center of the log.
Mm-hmm.
So what we'll do on a bigger log like this, since I'm only planning right now on getting two out of it, 2 8x10s, then the rest I'll make a lot of clear flooring boards and such. So that's what we'll do.
Okay.
Thank you. Like a big fish.
Okay, I got it.
See why I get attached to each 8x10. Each one can be a, some of them go so smoothly and come right out. Others, it's like being a midwife. Cutting it. But it's a beautiful board, and so each one of those adds up to a house. Of this size alone, it takes 66 of just this size that goes into the house. So that one I'll mark. That's a number one, and this is the best space, but it's got both faces are good to be exposed in the house. So I can call out a number one, and it can go anywhere in the house, even, you know, number one structural. So that's a good one.
How many more do you need?